for the word from the Lord. Amen? Okay. So today I have the privilege to give an inspirational message to you. Okay. Now let's take Jeremiah 29:11. Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. And it says so. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. And other versions goes on this way. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So this verse says, for I know the plans I have for you. So as I read, it is so very beautiful promise, but however, it rips up. We are trying to reconcile with the word of God, with the realities of life. That realities means the difficulties that we are going through, the pain, the sufferings of everyday life. But never forget that God chastens every son whom he receives. Okay, so there is a problem when we use it, because when you use Jeremiah 29:11, it is not addressing to us. Moreover, it is a corporate promise, right? It is not a singular promise, but it is a corporate promise. It is a letter written by Jeremiah to Israel in Babylonian captivity, in exile, because of their sin. So it was clearly a letter to the people in exile in Babylon. But God assured them that they will not be annihilated by when the Israelite people were taken captives by the Babylonians. God assured them, in spite of all these, that they will never be annihilated by the Babylonians. Instead, they will be benefited by the welfare of the captors. They will call out to him and he will restore their scattered nation, but that wasn't been fulfilled for 150 years. So just, it's so amazing to say, to hear. I know they had the promise of restoration and promise, but it was not been fulfilled for 150 years. Okay, so it is, so this promise, that Jeremiah 29:11, it is a proclamation given to a specific nation in a particular situation, prophesying the restoration of a future generation. So you should know the text completely. You should understand to whom it was given. It was a proclamation given to a specific nation in a particular situation, prophesying the restoration of a future generation. Okay, so it was not written to an individual to attain health or wealth. So we need to see the fulfillment of the promise the way the Old Testament people did. So you can see it in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 16. It says, it was not the earthly desire but a heavenly one. And that is what we should be looking to as we understand this text. So you know, I have told you what this promise is telling about, the history about it, and who wrote this, and for whom it has been prophesied. And now, how did the Old Testament people took those promises? It was not the earthly desire but the heavenly one. And we ought to take like that, just like them. So my topic for today is, everything is in the plan. What do you say? Everything. Come on, say it with me. Everything is in the plan. The moment we open our eyes in the morning is based on decision. Yes or not? The moment we open our eyes, how many of you can say yes? It is. If you open your eyes, if you are, you and I have to decide, you know, what to wear today. First thing for girls, what to wear, where to go, how to go, with what is the mode of my transportation will be, how I'm going to reach my destination. Or, you know, it goes on like that. Or whether, if a call rings up, you know, in a hurry, whether to you decide whether to take the call or not. So everything in your even today, as you walked into the church, you know, you decide from there, right from there. Now, where can I go and sit? Isn't it so? Yes. So it is a decision making wherever you go. In the every moment of your waking life, we face with decision making. So today, let me brief to you about three types of beneficial decision making. The first one is life adapting decision. We decide according to changing seasons of life. We adapt our life to culture, context, and new conditions. Yes or no? We decide it according to that. In 1 Corinthians 13:11, here we see Paul was alluding, saying, when I was a child, I spoke as a child, and I understood as a child, I thought as a child, and when I became a man, I put away the childish thing. When I became an adult, child decision was not adaptable. Amen. Child decision was no more adaptable because I have become a man. So what does that mean? We need to grow. Amen. Each and every day we need to grow. Say, we need to grow. Amen. The second one is a life adjusting decision. These are the decisions I made about the activities of my life. Do you get me what it is? Life adjusting decision is the decision I made about the activities of my life. So the express purpose is improving life in it, like staying in school, or you know, you have to go back from school, or I have to get a degree or not, I need to go for this job or not, like I'm just going to be an employee of a company, but I can own it. Yes, this is the life adjusting decisions that we make. The next one is life altering decisions. Those are the decisions we make where we can never be again the same after making the decision. I'll make it clear. Those are the decisions we make where we can never be again the same after making the decision. So we see, like I'll tell you there, therefore in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17 says, therefore, if any man is in Christ, he's a new creature, and old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Hallelujah. So there are some decisions that you can, if you once decide, it changes forever. So today I'd like to tell you that we know that certain decisions have consequences that you and I have to face. Amen. Have you gone through it? When we make decision, it is definitely that you need to face the consequence of it. So all of us know that they took in their walk of their life, in their journey, you can see that they took life adapting decision, life adjusting decision, and life altering decision. They took bad decisions to go after other gods. So despite the fact, because they knew who their God was, they know who he is, who Yahweh was, they know who their God is, that a God, a jealous God, despite the fact that you shall have no other God before me, God has already told them, in spite of that they went, despite the fact that they enjoyed God's favor, blessings, and Lord of promises, you see, they were carried, and they took all bad decisions, and because of that, they were carried into captivity by Babylonians, ultimately ended in 70 years of slavery. So it was all because of the bad decisions that they made, ended up in 70 years of slavery for them. Say, your decisions will impact. Amen. Your decisions will impact. So I'd like to answer you one question. I know all of you have this question then. What is life? Yes, do you have Isaac? What is life? So life is one challenge after other. Bills you can't pay, people you can't please, a past you can't shake, and an addiction you can't break. Life has another decision to make, and other problem to solve. Always a question I need somebody to answer. Amen. Have it? You have or not? You need somebody. You know, you want to ask. You know, what is this? Every day is a problem. Every day you go through something or the other that you want somebody to tell you what it is. So here on the text we see the children of Israel had problems, uncertainty, unpredictable, unexplainable, never-ending problems. But in the midst of that, God was with them, and he spoke words of health and hope to them. They went through a hell in their life because of captivity. But in midst of that, because God had a plan, he spoke health and hope to them. In Jeremiah 29:11, again, I'd like to tell you, I know the thoughts that I think towards you. Say, I am on God's mind. That means it's what? You are on God's mind. God is thinking about you. I know the thoughts that I think towards you. I am on God's mind. Come on, let us all say, I am on God's mind. So it's so precious, right? who is thinking, you don't have to worry whether anybody is thinking about you or not, but you know, God is always thinking about you. So I am on God's mind. Yes, he has a plan for you. He knows your destiny and the purpose for what you are. So in this uncertain life, unexplainable, unpredictable things that we do not know, we don't understand, but God knows every intricate details of you. You might be wondering what is going on in my life, but God knows everything what is going on in your life. For I know the thoughts. I need to let you know, God has a plan for your life. Amen. God has a plan. So we try to see and understand. I know you are working through something. You're working for something to find out what is God has for me in my life, and you are planning it out. But I tell you today that God has a plan for you. I know you're trying to figure it out in your life because you don't understand anything. But I tell you, God has a plan. And even today, if you don't know and don't believe, and nobody has told you, I'll tell you that today, that God has a plan in your life. God has a plan in your life. In all your insecurities, in all your imperfections, in all your idiocracies, in all your wrong choices, your bad choices, your failures, your flaws, in everything, whatever it may be, God has a plan. Whatever you are going through, all your imperfection, in your failures, don't worry. But God, you are on his mind, as I told you, and he has a plan for you. I know what type of plan it is. It is a custom plan, a original plan. It is contour, tailored plan. Not one size taper to fit all, you know, a plan, you know, for everybody. It is not that way. But it's stopped and touched just for you and you alone. He has a plan for each, and that means God has a plan for each and everybody seated over here. It is stopped, touched just for you, and that was his plan for you. So I'd like to let you know that in our lifespan, there will be some chains of events happening to you that cannot be altered, change, cannot be understood. But listen carefully. These happenings, events in life, are designed and orchestrated by God himself. Maybe you're wondering in your life, why, Lord, it is only in my life that is going through all. But I tell you, everything is designed and orchestrated by God. You know for what purpose? Just to test our faith, to perfect our character, to bring in us the spiritual maturity, calls us to grow in the knowledge of God, teaches us slowly to lean on him. Every time, you know, you go, you're really depressed, you go back, you know, God does something. Just come to me, he says, and he makes you to lean on him and solely to be pinned on him. This is what God does in every happenings of your life, in everything that you are going through. You know, to say, a decade back in my life, I heard my doctor saying that I will be dying in any moment. But I had an internal, because you know why, you know, the problem was with me that I had an internal bleeding, and as my ovaries burst, and as a result of my bladders, my urinary tract all got blocked, and I was in a very traumatic condition. Even if I think now, I just cannot, you know, digest it, how I was in that situation. So the enemy brought disaster in my life. I could hear death in my ears. But in the midst of that situation, God had a plan for me. Because it is easy to say from here that, you know, I heard it. But when you hear that, when somebody is coming to telling you that you are going to die, then just think how it was so painful. Not only painful, you know, everything is going to come to an end in your life. You know, that was the thing that I went through. But the very thing that I survived today is an indication that God is working in my life. Hallelujah. Because I experience it. I'm alive today, and I know God is working through me. So I know you are telling me, see, I don't understand anything what is going on in my life, and it makes no sense. And I'm not able to understand my life's happenings. But I tell you the fact that you are not killed. Are you killed? You are not destroyed. Are you destroyed? Whatever happens, God is with you, and he's making you to jump and cross over it. And this is the very fact that you survived, and you're running your life right now. You're sitting here. It is by grace. So you're running your life is an indication that God is working in your life. whatever it may be you're going through, I'll tell you, because you are alive, it means God is working in your life and he has a plan. So God is speaking to somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever happens, don't worry. Nothing can destroy you and nothing can kill you, because God has a plan and you are in the mind of God. You may not understand everything what God is doing or what is going to do in the next season of your life, but only think that you need to have faith that he has included me in the plan. Amen. Yes, you are included. Amen. God knows everything about you. For my thoughts, you know, already we have seen this, Isaiah 55:8. For my thoughts and are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways. My thoughts and ways are higher than yours, God says. Not only that, you know what, the God whom we worship, he neither slumbers nor sleeps. In Psalms 121:3, we know who our God is. If we know well who our God is, I'm sure that you can go this race. He knows your thoughts before it enters into you. Amen. How many of you can say? He knows, because he knows everything. He's all-knowing God. He knows before you're going to think something, before it enters into your mind, he knows what you're going to think. He's an omnipresent God. God everywhere at the same time. Hallelujah. God who showed up on nowhere, spoke to nobody, let there be, and everything came forth. Amen. Hallelujah. Who can know the mind of God, the omnipotent God, the all-powerful, that the heavens is his throne and the earth is his footstool, but still he holds the earth in his palms of his hand. Who can know the mind of God? He has a plan. He's all-knowing. He's omniscient, all-knowing God. God knows everything about you. He's thinking about you. Wow, hallelujah. How nice it is when you hear, he's always thinking, oh yes, who is my parents if they don't even think? Even my friends, they don't, they've forgotten me. But I know my God is thinking about me. And he knows what all your struggles. He knows what you have not given up, what you did last summer. And he knows even before your mama met your daddy. Hallelujah. Even before that, he knows. Hallelujah. Yes, he knows even before your mama met your daddy, and before the cycle in the womb, he knows you. He knows you before the foundation of the world, and he knows the number of your hairs on your head. Amen. Hallelujah. He can come and say, this is the 22nd hair, this is a 345 hair. He can come and count and say, this is the hair. He knows you through and through. He has all the details, intricate details about you. Understand, there is nothing more important to God than his glory. He needs glory. Amen. Hallelujah. So remember this. Never forget when you're going through some things that are happening in your life that disturbs you. Remember this, that you are created to give God glory in his own image. Amen. Hallelujah. God's plan is to give you an expected end. Yes, that verse goes on, right? We shall read that verse 29:11. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Now you might be wondering, what is this expected end that God is going to lead me to? Okay, God's plan is to give you an expected end. Maybe you're out of the will of God right now, but I tell you, though you are out of the will of God, but you are in his plan. Amen. And he wants to give you an expected end, bring you to an expected end. For this, he has to take you through a process. To bring you through to an expected end, God is going to take you through a process in your life. His plan is very simple, but the process is very, very difficult. In this process, you will have lonely days, restless nights, fear situation. You will be let down your days, and all the situation that you need to go through, these are the process. But God knows the right way to bring you to an expected end. He knows the right stimuli that will grab you to your knees before people grab you insane. You know, when you go through many problems and many happenings in a life, people talk about us, but God knows, and through all these process, he will drag you towards him on your knees. Amen. Hallelujah. He knows the right temperature for your fiery furnace. He knows knows how low to leave you. He knows he will let you down sometimes, but it is all for your good and for my good. He knows how many car accidents to let you walk out without a scratch. You know, that is for his glory. This is what he does in our life. Hallelujah. Do you get me? Are you coming with me? Amen. He knows everything. Amen. Now in the process, right? Now we are in the process. How many of you can get me? Yes? Are you in the process? Amen. So he shapes, he develops, he molds your character. If you are in the process, I know God is speaking to you. If you are going through the process, and in this process is that he's going to shape you, he's going to develop, mold and mold your character. So in this process, God is pushing us to a better limits. Amen. Though you are comfortable, you think, yes, everything is fine. But he wants you to push you to a different level and a better limits. And he, you know, sometimes he passes us like the silver in the refiner's fire. So let's never forget that I am in the process in God's plan. Never think when you are in the process that God has let you down. But you are in his plan. You believe it. We shall take, you know, when you take Paul, St. Paul's, he went to the Lord and he cried out saying, I have a thorn in the flesh. He prayed three times to the Lord to remove it. Did God remove it? He just let it there as a navigation system to his expected end. Hallelujah. How many of you get me? He asked God to let the thorn be taken away from him. But God said, let it be there and it will be a navigation system towards your expected end. Hallelujah. So I tell you, never forget, your sickness is on God's plan. Your suffering in his plan. Your heartaches, your heartbreaks in his plan. Your failures are in his plan. So God has a plan to perfect each and every one of us. So this is the process, the plan you have. You will become perfect. But whatever means necessary to an expected end. So he sends you through fire. He sends you through floods. What is an expected end? Again, you'll ask me. Expected end is God's expectation for each and every one of us is the expected end. So God wants to perfect your imperfection. Therefore, he's working on you. He's working behind the scene. He's working through you, for you. So everything you see doesn't look what you had in mind. Amen? That is what we see every time. When you are alone, you say, Lord, I thought all this will happen this way, but everything is going in a different way. So if you are seeing like that, and if you go through such experience, never forget that you are in the mind of God, and God has a plan, and he has brought you and is bringing you towards that expected end, the expectation of God to make you perfect from your imperfection. And God is working through you and for you. So everything is in God's plan. Hallelujah. Did you get this? Amen. So never forget whatever things are happening. So all that you need to do is just go to him. Just stay calm and quiet. Lord, I know you're taking through this process to make me perfect. And I know that you will take me home one day. Amen. Never forget. And he is there and always with you. Amen. Let's close our eyes in prayer. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Master. We praise you, Lord, that everything is in his plans. The plan is simple. The process is difficult. Oh, the happenings. Lord, we are going through the process. And I thank you and I praise you, Lord. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Amen. To take us through the process and to attain the perfection, your expectation to the expected end. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Help each and every one of them over seated over here, Lord, that they are in your mind and you are all knowing God and you know everything, happenings of their lives, every intricate details, everything, the thoughts even that is reaching into their minds even before that you know what is going on. Yes, Lord. So I know that you are going to do great things in their lives. Thank you, Lord. You bless them, Lord. Bless them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, as your presence is here, Lord, bless each and every child over here, Master. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Master. I thank you and I praise you for your awesome presence, Master. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. And as they go out into the world throughout this week, Lord, your presence, let your presence lead them, guide them, guard them, let them get favor from men, give them good understanding, wisdom and knowledge, help them to go through their life, a victorious life, Master, to glorify wherever they are and lead a testimonial life. Thank you, Lord. I thank you and I praise you, Lord. Let them be filled with the anointing and this anointing break the yoke. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you. I give all glory to you. In Jesus' name, we ask this prayer. Amen and amen. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And forget not all his benefits. Amen and amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide with each and every one of us.